Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I want to show you how to make a simple greeting card for the winter holidays using Illustrator. This is the card you are going to make. It's a simple greeting card made with hand-drawn graphics. You can use your own hand-drawn illustrations or purchase vector illustrations from sites like Creative Market. These vectors are actually from my new winter flowers collection, but you can download a free sample from my blog. Just check the video description for the download link. Open Illustrator and create a new document. I'm going to make a card that's 6 inches by 4 inches. That's 15 centimeters by 10 centimeters. It works well with an A6 envelope because it's a standard photo size, and you can also print it on photo paper. Make sure you leave a bleed of 0.125. Set the color mode to CMYK and the raster effect or resolution to 300 pixels per inch, then click create to continue. Now that our workspace is ready, let's open the flower illustrations, select all of them. I'm going to press Ctrl C to copy them, move back to the greeting card, and then press Ctrl V to paste them in the document. So let's make them smaller, and I'm going to move them over here. Let's create a background for our greeting card. Because I have so many colors here, I am going to use a very light background. So let's switch to the rectangle tool, and I'm going to use this off-white or blush color that comes with the hand-drawn illustrations. Then I'm going to click on the artboard, and I want to make a rectangle that's 6.25 inches wide and 4.25 inches high. The 0.25 inches is the bleed. Now let's switch to the selection tool, and I am going to align the rectangle to the artboard. Next, I am going to switch to the ellipse tool. The shortcut is L. Change the color to white, and I am going to draw a circle in the middle of the artboard. Hold down the shift key while you draw to create a circle. Now switch to the selection tool and let's center the circle. The circle, as you see here, will help us create the flower arrangement, and you can add the text over it. Now I'm going to go to the layers panel. If you can see it, you can open it from window layers or by pressing F7, and I am going to click on this arrow to open it. And first I'm going to select the background layers, and I am going to move them to the bottom of the layers panel. And then I am going to lock both of them, so now I cannot move them. This will help me when I arrange the flowers. I am going to start with the two fir branches and one of the flowers. And I'm going to move them over here, and then let's zoom in. And I'm going to make a floral arrangement that will be the starting point of our flower wreath, and then I'm going to add the rest of the elements. I'm going to make a copy of one of the branches, and I'm going to use the reflect tool for that because it will not only copy it, but also change its rotation. So now that we have this little arrangement, we can copy the rest of the branches. Let's also select the candy cane and move it over here. And I'm just going to make all of them smaller, and I am probably going to copy some of them to add them to our floral arrangement. So now that we have arranged the branches, I'm going to add the rest of the elements to fill in the spaces. When you're happy with the way your flowers look, use the selection tool to select everything and then group them. Now I'm going to switch to the type tool, and I'm going to use a font called Beautiful Day. It's a handwritten font that works well with this greeting card, and I am going to type my message. If you want, you can leave this area empty and write your message on the greeting card. Now I'm going to select the text and I am going to create outlines, and then I'm going to group it. Now let's select everything and group the items again. So let's save the file. First I'm going to save it as an Illustrator file, so go to File, Save, give it a new name and then save it. So let's also save it as a PDF. Go to File, Save As, choose Adobe PDF as the file type and then click Save. I won't make many changes to the PDF options, but go to Marks and Bleeds, make sure Trim Marks is checked, and also make sure Use Document Bleed Settings is checked, then click on Save PDF. This is how your PDF should look like. You can see here the trim marks that Illustrator automatically adds, so you don't have to worry about adding them manually. All you have to do now is print the file. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!